Before we go ahead, this differential calculus is the centered or is the center of this concept of derivative. So what was the motivation or the, you know, push to the derivative? We want to define the tangent lines on the graphs. We want to find the slope of this tangent. But the integral which we are learning today is motivated, or the push is the problem of defining and calculating the area of the region. So if you have this curve, we want this area. This is given by integral. So if a function f is differentiable in any interval a, say a to b, this its derivative, that is f dash, exists in this interval, then there is a natural question that f dash, given f dash at each point, are you able, or are we able to determine the function? If this f dash is given, the derivative is given, can we find out the initial function? So the functions could have possibly, you know, this function is, can be given any name, but here we'll call them as antiderivative. The antiderivative, if you are able to get rid of this dash, f dash x, then it would be fx, so it would be the antiderivative. So antiderivative is called nothing but indefinite integral. Indefinite integral is nothing but the antiderivative, or the reverse of derivative, or the negation of derivative. So this process of finding the antiderivative is called as the integration. Various situations we will see. If you want to find out, say you have the instantaneous velocity of an object at any instant. So the question will be, are you able to determine the position of the object at any instant? Yes, we are. So in various practical and theoretical situations, you will see integration involved. So the development, why this integral calculus has taken its place, is to solve, or the efforts which were put in to solve certain problems. First is finding out the function from the derivative, that is the inverse of the derivative, antiderivative. And the second is the problem of finding the area bounded by the graph of a function under certain conditions. So these two problems, they give forms of integral. We'll see two types of integrals, indefinite and definite integrals. If we combine these two, indefinite and definite, they will be called as integral calculus. So integral calculus is nothing but the combination of indefinite and definite integrals. So there is a connection also called the fundamental theorem of calculus, fundamental theorem of calculus, between these two, indefinite and definite. That will enhance, or that will propagate the thought of making definite integral as a practical tool of solution in science and engineering. So the definite integral will be used, and we'll see when we are going to see the problems like the economics, finance, probability, various disciplines we are able to involve it. So we'll talk about the indefinite and definite integrals and all the elementary properties with some techniques of integration.